While LiveHome 3D offers a large number of ready-made stairways in the built-in library, in many cases, you might want to use a different one. You can try looking for one from a third-party resource, such as Trimble 3D Warehouse, and then import it into LiveHome 3D as a 3D model. Alternatively, you can design a custom staircase using a 3D modeling application of your choice. However, it is also possible to create a staircase directly in LiveHome 3D. And in this video, we'll show you how. This tutorial is based on an article written by LiveHome 3D enthusiast Matt Knowles. The link to the article can be found in the description. On his website, you can also explore many wonderful buildings created in LiveHome 3D. In this video, we will use the building block tools, which require pro features in LiveHome 3D. If you don't have access to pro features, you can use objects from the Shapes category in the Object Library to simulate building blocks. We're going to design a section of an exterior staircase, which can later be expanded into a more complex structure by adding landings and additional sections. When constructing it, think of the staircase as if it were being built out of wood. First, let's create a riser using a rectangular building block. The standard stairway has a rise of 8 inches and a tread of 10 inches. So the first block for the riser will be 1 inch by 7 inches by 4 feet, since the stairway is going to be 4 feet wide. Next, using another rectangular building block, create the tread with dimensions of 10 inches by 1 inch by 4 feet. To add a bullnose, use the Edit Contour command from the context menu to pull one end into a semicircle. Position it next to the riser. Next, let's group the riser and the tread, then duplicate them, positioning each duplicate so that they step up accordingly. Once you've added the correct number of riser-tread groups, group them all together. Then raise the elevation of the group to create space for the first stringer. Our stringer will be 2 inches thick, so let's raise the elevation to 2 inches. To draw the stringer, use a building block polygon. Before drawing, position some guidelines for better precision. You can also build a rectangle, rotate it, and then edit the contour to cut off unnecessary parts, similar to how a carpenter would do. Keep in mind that building blocks function like raw lumber, allowing you to shape them as needed. Once the stringer is ready, set its height to 2 inches to match the intended thickness. After creating the first stringer, duplicate it, place it above the first one, and raise its elevation to 4 foot 2 inches to move it into the position for the other side. To add the spindles, you may use a horizontal cylinder with dimensions of 1.5 inches by 3 feet by 1.5 inches. Duplicate and place the spindles however you want to lay them out. Then group them together. Duplicate the spindle group and change the elevation of each group so they're centered in the stringer, or however you want them. Now group everything together and slightly raise the elevation to allow space for the handrail, as it will extend slightly beyond the stringer. To create the handrails, use building blocks. Draw a rectangle of the desired size. To adjust the thickness, use the Height field in the inspector. Rotate the handrail using the rotation handle so that it matches the angle of the top of the spindles. Duplicate the handrail and adjust the elevation of both handrails so they are centered on each row of spindles. One important point here, since we're going to merge everything in the next step, if you want to have more than one texture applied to the stair assembly, do it now. In our example, let's add different textures to each component so you can change them later if needed. Once the textures are applied, select everything and merge all components into a single object. It's a good idea to make a copy first so that you always have the individual units available if you want to go back and make a small change. After merging the components into one assembly, You can use the type and representation settings to rotate the entire structure 90 degrees on the x-axis so that it is correctly oriented in your project. The section we've just built can serve as part of a more complex stairway by adding landings and additional sections.